This is a Fox News alert. We actually have results now in the Arizona special election. This is the latest test of the so-called blue wave, the strength also of the Trump-supporting key GOP districts. He won this one big. Let's check in with Alicia Acuna. She is live on the ground there from the Grand Canyon State. What can you tell us tonight, Alicia?
Hi, Shannon. Yes, well, we just heard a big cheer go up here at State Senator Debbie Lesko's watch party here. She's the Republican here who has just found out that she has been victorious in this special election race to fill the seat of disgraced Republican Congressman Trent Franks. He left in December, and it has been a race that actually no one thought was actually going to be a race. This is a Republican stronghold here in the state of Arizona, a very deeply red district that's made up of mostly white, retired Republicans, very conservative, very active voters, and they have come to the call of Debbie Lesko here and Republicans. However, I should tell you, the reason we are here and the reason we are watching is because this is a district in which, since 2012, Democrats haven't even put up a candidate. This time they did. Dr. Haral Teperneni, she's a doctor here in this state, and she's a Democrat who was able to outraise the Republican here. She had attack ads. She had some headliners coming up. Gabby Giffords coming to her assist. And she was able to kind of close in a little bit in polling, but really couldn't pull it through because, really, when it comes down to it, as you said, this is a district that Donald Trump won big by 21 points back in 2016. So not a surprise that she has won here. The big question tonight was going to be the spread, whether or not she could pull out a double-digit lead, because anything less could become a message, a wake-up call to Republicans come November. Shannon?
Yeah, and I know that we were thinking we might get these results a little bit later, Alicia, but it seems like a lot of the early balloting may have factored in here as well. And you gave us a little bit of the demographic makeup of what goes on there in that district. It seemed like it was a pretty tough hill to climb for the Democrat. But as you said, this may be more about the spread than about who actually won.
Yes, this is actually about the spread, and we're still getting the results. Right now, Lesko is leading by 6 points, I believe, at the last check from the Secretary of State's office. They're waiting to see if this is a double-digit lead. I was talking to former Arizona Governor Jan Brewer, and she even agreed that, you know, anything less than a double-digit spread at the end of the day, even though a win is a win, it still could be a wake-up call, because we do have those midterms that we're talking about here. In talking to State Senator Lesko, she said they really want to stop that momentum that they believe Democrats have right now from other special elections that we've seen, Pennsylvania, for example. They really want to put a stop to that here in Arizona and get Democrats' eyes off of this state, especially this district, as we head into the midterms. Shannon.
All right, Alicia Acuna, they are covering this race all day and tonight on the ground for us. Thank you so much.